Most of you should know who he is. If you follow high school basketball at all, you've heard of Oak Hill Man Academy. You've heard of Coach Smith. He just finished his 27th year at Oak Hill Academy. So Oak Hill has been good forever. It's been good for as long as you guys have known. It's not that Coach Smith just showed up and took over the program. He's been there through that's brought it to this national level. I'll give you some of his stats before he comes up and talks to you. His overall record as a high school basketball coach is 860 wins to 53 losses. 860 wins to 53 losses. He has the highest winning percentage in high school basketball history. 94% winning percentage. He's had four 40-win seasons, and he's had a stretch where he had a 65-game win streak between two seasons. He's been named the National High School Coach of the Year by USA Today in 1994, 1999, 2004, and 2012. Four times he's got USA Today High School Basketball Coach of the Year. Only the next closest person has only won it twice. He's won it two times more than any other high school coach. He's also the only coach to win the Nation of High School Coach of the Year award two times. He's won eight high school basketball national championships, not state championships, national championships. 93, 94, 99, 2001, 2004, 2005, 2007, and this past year, 2012. And then Oak Hill went 44-0 and won the national championship. He's coached 28 McDonald's All-Americans, more than any other high school in the country. And he's coached 27 NBA draftees and over 135 Division I athletes. Graduate of Asbury College from Kentucky. Coach Smith's going to come up here and talk to you. Give him a round of applause.
Things I think you need to do to allow you to be as quick as you possibly can play. You don't have to be the quickest out of the floor. You got to be as quick as your body will let you. Right? You can do that. All of you can do that. You can't just walk there and say, I'm slow, and I'm not having an egg, whatever. There's things you can do to allow yourself to be the best player you possibly can. Right? What your body will allow you to do. And there's a lot of hard work. Don't remember anything I tell you today. Alright? Remember this. Be the teammate that you want to play with. Does that make sense to you? Be the teammate that you want to play with. You don't have anything else, remember that today. What does that mean to you? Somebody raise your hand. Be the teammate you want to play with. What does that mean? I play with him, he jacks up shots. Alright? He dribbles when he doesn't need to. He don't like to guard his man. Right? He don't want to be so he won't be found. I want to play with that guy. Is that how I want to be? Right. You being the teammate that you want to play with. And that'll allow you the best player you possibly. Have the positive attitude that way. Don't pound so the guy over here jacks up a shot and you don't get the ball. He takes three shots, this guy takes two shots, you haven't got a shot. That's defeating the first. That's not helping your team. That's not helping you be a better player. Alright, I'm gonna tell you some, I'm gonna try to give you some advice. How many of you play on an organized team? All of you, I hope. Okay. How many of you like to get playing time? You better all raise your hand. We all like to play, right? Okay, I'm gonna give you some advice for you to impress your coach, alright? Things that a coach knows. I watched you guys here today. I was here for how long? 15 minutes? I sat over in this court. I saw I didn't see everybody play, but I saw most of you play about 8 or 10 minutes. If you say, coach, pick a guy or two that you want, from what I saw, here's my guys. I think this guy right here, y'all play with him today? I think he's on my team. Anybody know why? First thing he does is pass first guy. Alright? I never saw him jog down the floor and low. When I saw him turn it over, I saw him run back. Okay? He's not the best shooter, but he can make some shots. His technique's not that great, but he makes some shots. He also practices your shots up. Repetition. Alright? He's one guy to pick. Let me have this one. I'll pick this guy right here. Not that he's big. Alright? I saw him, what he do when he play. He attacked the basket. He attacked the rim. He didn't finish every time, but he attacked the basket. I like players that attack the basket. Alright? That's in 10 minutes, I'm just picking two guys out. There's a couple others too. There's a couple smaller guys I thought I would put you on my team. I would pick you to play. You said pick five guys, coach, let's go play. I'd pick you guys. I think you can beat the rest of them. Alright? That's just my opinion you watch guys. And I'm a coach. You all have a coach you want to impress. Alright? There's things you can do. I'm going to try to keep you involved here too. Do, to impress the coach, to make the coach notice you. Alright? What does he think besides, don't think of offense and defensive basketball. Just think of being a player on my team. Okay? What would be important to me? What are some things you can do to impress him? Not on the floor right now. Off the court, what would it be? Look in the eye when you talk, that's respect. That's respect, okay? I would hope you respect your coach. I don't like players to go home. The players come visit me, and I get some kids to transfer, and they sit down in front of my desk, and they say, well, why do you want to transfer? Why do you want to go home here? Eight out of 10 of them, the first thing they say was, man, my coach said, I'm turned off right away. Even if they're good players, I get turned off. I'm a coach too. I don't want my players talking about me that way. I don't want this guy talking about his coach back. How do I know when he comes to me he's not going to be doing the same thing? Obviously, his attitude is not right, okay? You got to have a good attitude, a positive attitude, all right? What's something else? First thing I tell my players in their first team meeting, this is very simple. Be on time. Be on time for practice. Be on time for class. Be on time for study hall. Be on time for everything. Team meetings, all right? And then I notice when I walk in the gym, I notice who's in the gym for first. In second. I notice who leaves practice first. Who stays practice last. I notice those things. All coaches. Alright? Not only on